Access for Everyone, breaking down digital barriers for people with disabilities. Topic 1, digital accessibility. 3 points about the law.
Welcome. My name is David.
And I'm Jessica. David and I both work for the U.S. Department of Education's Office for Civil Rights.
Alongside our colleagues at OCR, we created this series of videos to help you learn more about digital accessibility for people with disabilities. These videos are for a wide audience: school administrators, web designers, disability services, teachers and professors, IT services, students, parents, and community members, to name a few. So it's possible that not every video will be applicable to you.
We'll be talking about the main things that we see regularly in our work: the need for keyboard testing, sufficient color contrast, logical reading order, meaningful alternative text for graphic images and photographs, video captioning, and a few other topics.
This will give you a good start, and you'll be able to find additional in-depth resources online from a variety of sources for each of these topics. Pick and choose the content that best helps you. Our goal is simply to help you understand some basics.
At the end of each video, you'll also see OCR contact information. Use that to reach out and ask for help. Our team is full of people who are passionate about accessibility for people with disabilities, which really means communicating your message to everyone.
In this video, we'll share 3 key points for you to know about disability law, school websites, and accessible online learning. If you're an administrator at your school serving students anywhere from kindergarten to postgraduate studies, or a student, parent or guardian, or community member, this information will help you better understand your school's legal requirements for digital accessibility and how you can help.
First, the 2 relevant laws. The U.S. Department of Education's Office for Civil Rights helps enforce 2 civil rights laws that address the rights of students, parents, caregivers, and community members with disabilities, with a focus on ensuring access to educational institutions, services, programs, or activities. The first is Section 504 of the Rehabilitation Act, which covers recipients of federal funding. These include school districts, charter schools, parent information centers, and colleges and universities that receive this funding or other assistance from the U.S. Department of Education. The second is Title II of the Americans with Disabilities Act, sometimes referred to simply as Title II. Title II applies to state and local government entities, including public schools and libraries, regardless of whether they receive federal funds. Public schools that receive federal funding are covered by both laws. The U.S. Department of Justice interprets Title II. OCR's Title II work focuses on public schools and libraries.
Next, here are 3 key points for you to know. First, both Section 504 and Title II prohibit discrimination against people with disabilities. Second, both laws require that students with disabilities and others who have rights under these laws have an equal opportunity to participate in everything a school does. Under Section 504, this is called the recipient's program or activity, while Title II refers to a public entity's services, programs, or activities. The scope of these laws is broad in prohibiting disability-based discrimination. For example, a school's services, programs, or activities may include course registration, book and t-shirt sales, cafeteria menus, and employment-related services, in addition to athletic programs and other activities. With online learning, services, programs, or activities may also include digital course materials, online assignments, lectures over a video conferencing platform, and online chat rooms or discussion boards used for class. These are not exhaustive lists, but they should give you a good idea of the wide scope of these laws.
Third, in general, all schools covered by these laws must ensure that students, parents, caregivers, and community members with disabilities are able to enjoy the same benefits and services as their peers without disabilities, unless doing so imposes what the law calls a fundamental alteration or undue burden. Additionally, under Section 504, elementary and secondary students must receive what's called a free appropriate public education, or FAPE. These topics are not covered in this video series. To learn more, please see OCR's website.
Many schools follow an accessibility standard to gauge whether they are complying with their responsibilities. The Department of Education does not endorse any particular set of standards, and none is specifically required by the Section 504 or the Title II regulations. But many schools have adopted the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, or WCAG.
For next steps on ensuring digital accessibility in your school, join us for the next video in this series. We hope this information is helpful as you work through digital accessibility issues.
This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR or email us at OCR@ED.gov.